Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to show you how I made this big buckle card. I got the instructions from Split Coast Stampers, and it opens up like this. Inside it says, no lion, you're the best. A little lion on the outside. It's really cute and it's really easy to make. The pieces that you're going to need are a piece of cardstock that's 5.5 by 7, and then this is scored at 4 1/4. I didn't score it because I know you've seen me do that before. The second piece is the inside of the card, which is 4 by 5 1/4. And then the belt is 1 5/8 by 5.5, and it's scored at 3.5. And then I rounded the corners off. And then another thing that you're going to need is a word window punch. And I think you can get these about anywhere. This one is a Stampin' Up! Window word punch. And once this is scored, you just slip this in here and kind of score or punch the window wherever you want. It fits really easy. If you go in too far, it's going to open up. So just punch that little opening wherever you want. And then I've already stamped the back of my sunflower piece. And you're going to want to stamp towards the left side, because when this goes in, that's what's going to be covered. And then I've already put glue on the back of here. So I try to line it up where I think it's going to be. Slip that in there. Line this up. Gonna slip this in here so then it'll close. And then I kind of push. They say to glue both, but I don't want mine glued on back yet. I kind of want the buckle on first. And then I kind of make sure that that's glued down on the back of there. And then I glue the rest of it down to the inside of the card, making sure my buckle's going to fit in there again. And then you can decorate this any way you want to. I took the Expedition paper pack from Close to My Heart and cut a piece for this inside part. I just kind of wanted more color on my card. Line that up, and I'll have all these measurements for you. And then I also decorated my buckle, which again, you don't necessarily have to. It's kind of just what you want to do. But I liked all the colors. Oh, and then what would have been really good is if I would have put that on there first, but let me show you how you can do that. If you want to add something, just glue this down here. See, you can see my mistake. And then just take the word window punch again and line it up. Punch it out. And that still worked. There we go. And then I decorated this with the July stamp of the month from Close to My Heart, which is Life's a Jungle. It's cute, it has some cute sayings on it. And I did use watercoloring pencils. I used Desert Sand, Autumn Terracotta, and Gold Rush. And the first time I did this, I didn't use my water. I just colored with them and I didn't use my water brush. And I thought that would be kind of a cool thing to do, would be to actually use my watering colored pencils for what they're for. So this is just a water brush. And you just kind of, there's water in the end of this. You just kind of motion around. And it doesn't have to be perfect, because they always say that watercoloring isn't perfect. And then once I do one color, I just kind of wipe that color off. And just kind of go around, and what that kind of does, or what that does do, is kind of molds all the lines. You really don't see any coloring pencil lines when you do this. There we go. So then he's ready to go on the front. Up top here. And then I just have jute that I got from, I think, Target. Tie it around my belt for a little bit of that natural fiber feel. And then come together. So there it is, a big buckle card. No lion, you're the best. Thanks for stopping by and happy stamping.
Yeah.